This mid-year layout update video features new items and scenery details for your inspiration. Hello and welcome to a mid-year layout update video. Yes, I think it's great to, you know, kick off the new season, which this is, autumn, winter 2019. We're looking back to what's been accomplished on the layout during the past season. And the good thing with that is that if you find something that, you know, oh my god, that, I want to do that, it looks awesome, then there is a tutorial for each and every of those things already published on the channel. So it's just to browse the index and you will find it there. Then I got this message from a lady in the US called Mandy Wilson. She's a home social worker, and she met with some elderly guys, probably my age or so. And then she noticed that they were interested in trains. So she purchased a piece of track and some trains, and this was an instant hit. So now they're watching the videos from my channel and maybe some other channels, get inspired, and this has really boosted the activities on this home. So I want to send a regard to Mandy Wilson. That's the kind of care I would like when I grow a bit older. And all the best to the Coldwell Care Train Club. My layout is a so-called folded dog bone, and here we're standing at the south end. Let's start some of the new locomotives on the layout. This is a BR-140 in Ocean Blue and beige color scheme. They were built in the late 50s for the German state railways. I love the color scheme of this set. Another amendment to my rolling stock is the brand new Dostox. Hey, just can't run steamers all day. It was also kind of test to see if I can push a train set like this around the layout. And it turns out it works just fine, even though I have steep inclines and sharp curves. This set of Dostox are being pushed around by a BR-140 in red color scheme. This spring I started to work on a city front. I'm currently building on the station in front of the city, which will be not the city station but maybe the south or north type station. The train exits the station to the south through tunnel portals under the city park. My idea here is that this should be a recreational area for the inhabitants of the city. Here you can go running, having a picnic, or even play with your friends. One can also just sit under the 150-year-old oak. A few blocks away, someone has opened up an hydrant and is showering in the street, cooling down this hot summer day. Another new amendment to the layout is the construction site at Himmelsboda. There is a foreman here who seems to be on top of the situation, but I don't know. It seems like they have problems with the drain, but not everyone is working all that hard to solve it. This method of making trees based on natural twigs from my garden is also something new I've started with this summer. Aunt Agda is waiting for the post office to open. There are new flower pots also outside the station. Alright, time is now 9:20, and then the goods train arrives to the harbor area. Some of the cars will be left there to load and unload, whilst some of them will continue on the ferry boat.
The seed sacks on the dock has been unloaded from a ship. This type of sack can easily be made using clay and a piece of nylon cloth, and then glued down onto pallets. Here's the layout viewed from the north end, where we find on the top level the locomotive station. I've put the central station and the media keyboard into a drawer, controlling the trains with the cell phone. This is also a new amendment to the rolling stock. It's a BR-110 in blue paint scheme. I acquired this together with a set of blue and green passenger cars. This summer I've also started to assemble catenary or overhead wires for the electrical trains. Adding catenary was far more work intense than I anticipated, so I will guess I will continue with this over the coming 2 years. These cars are really nice. I love the coloring and the detail level. They also run well and cause no problems. As you might or might not have noticed, my trains are running left-hand traffic. That's because I have a Swedish theme for the layout, even though the rolling stock consists of both German, Swiss and Danish trains. A new amendment for the Swedish rolling stock is the new RA locomotive. 10 of these locomotives were manufactured between the years 1955 to 1961. The model you see here is brand new, and I haven't even added the stuff from the goodie bag yet. The loco is currently pulling a set of 30s style passenger cars.
I hope you liked this layout tour. If you did, please help others to find it by giving it a thumbs up. And there are a lot of new videos coming up, one every 2 weeks during the autumn and winter now. So next video is August 30. That one will be about foliage. So stay tuned by subscribing. And don't forget to click on the bell, and you will get a notification once next video gets live. Until that happens, see you.